I'm Tom, and this is my review of the RepRapElectro RAMBo. So I've used a few different 3D printer mainboards before, ranging from the dinosaur of boards, the RAMs, over the super cheap Sangon Ululu, and the newer Melty to the bread and butter printer board. Now what I have here today is the RAMBo, which is kind of the nicer and newer version of the RAMs. And just like the RAMs, the RAMBo was designed by Ultimachine. Since every manufacturer changed a couple of things when they make the boards, and so did RepRapElectro, who sent me this board, I want to start out with what the reference design and hence the official RAMBo looks like, and then move on to whether or not RepRapElectro are doing a decent job of manufacturing it. This is RAMBo, and this is the RepRap Arduino Mega Compatible motherboard. The design centers around the fact that this board is basically an Arduino Mega 2560, which is the center part, along with 5 stepper drivers down here and the full set of corresponding power transistors and thermistor inputs for a full dual extruder setup. In fact, there are a total of 5 power outputs, 2 of which are limited in their output current by either the board design or the transistor used. So those are labeled as fan outputs, which makes sense. You can still hook up a really beefy fan to the fan zero output though. Staying with the power components, the RAMBo has 3 independent supply rails instead of the 2 typically seen on the RAMs, or just 1 on some other boards, which means that you can use different power supplies and voltages for each, the heated bed, the hot ends, and the motor drivers. Or you can tie them together and use one beefy 12 volt or 24 volt supply for all parts. The supply for the logic part of the board, like the Atmega and the logic side of the motor drivers, is provided by a step-down converter, which is a nice step up from the regular linear voltage regulators. Now, right next to the buck converter, you might notice some parts that you rarely see on 3D printer electronics. Fuses. Now, they might sound like there's not much to get excited about here, but instead of using no fuses at all or using self-resetting polyfuses, which often cause more issues than they solve, the RAMBo uses real fuses. One for each voltage rail. The most loaded one for the bed gets an automotive blade fuse, and the other 2 rails are each secured by one of these nano fuses, which come in these holders so they're easy to swap out in case something should have gone wrong. There is also some reverse polarity protection built into the RAMBo's design. Overall, that's a really nice power design so far. Moving on to the motor drivers, you might notice 2 or 3 things here. 1, the driver chips are soldered directly onto the board. This is good and bad in a couple ways. It does allow for better cooling if you want it, even through the bottom of the board. But it also means that you can't really replace a blown driver. Now, I haven't killed the driver in a long while, and if you're a tiny bit careful, you should get along with this just fine. But I know it's going to bother some people, so for those, there is the option of hooking up an external driver through these pins. 2, there are no microstepping jumpers, like on the RAMs and pretty much every other board. That's because microstepping is controlled by the onboard Atmega microcontroller via software, which I think is pretty neat, but usually you just set that to 16 times microstepping anyways and be done with it. 3, there are also no fiddly potentiometers for adjusting the current to each motor. Now that is a huge step forward because just like microstepping, you can now set the current through software. There is an ADC chip on board that does the job the potentiometers used to do. So no more adjusting them that tiny bit clockwise to keep your motor from skipping and then realizing you have set it to 1.1 volts instead of the 0.8 volts that you read was recommended somewhere. With this, you simply set it and forget it, and in case you ever need to adjust the current, you can do so in a reproducible way. The drivers themselves are the classic Allegro A4982 chips, which work well for normal printers, even if they are not quite as powerful as the newer Texas Instruments DRV8825 chips. The motor output for Z is split into 2 connectors, which can supply 2 motors in parallel for printers that use 2 motors for the Z axis. Moving on to the logic part of the RAMBo, you've got the option of hooking up all 6 possible end stops and 4 thermistors. As far as expansion options go, you get a serial port, SPI, analog pins, and a generic expansion header, so if you want to, you can easily hook up an LCD screen or an SD card reader. Also on board are in-circuit serial programming headers for both the main processor as well as the tiny one that is only responsible for interfacing with your computer. So in case you manage to screw up the bootloader and brick your board, you can always recover it if you have a programmer at hand. Now I think that covers what the RAMBo design can do. Hint, it does practically everything you'd possibly need, unless you're thinking about using that insane E3D Kraken water-cooled quad hotend. There are specialized boards that cater to those needs, but for everyone else, the RAMBo is a pretty good choice. So how well did RepRapElectro do when it comes to actually manufacturing the board? As it turns out, pretty well actually. The build quality is absolutely perfect as far as I can tell. All the solder joints are done properly, and the only thing that isn't spot on is this one transistor that is off by half a millimeter, but of course working just fine. RepRapElectro chose to use these green detachable screw connectors, which seem to be a very popular option these days and generally work well. Just keep in mind that these are running right on the edge of their current capabilities for the connectors for the heated bed, as they are only rated for 10 amps of current. IEC would rate them for 15 amps, but either way, if you have a really beefy heated bed and want to make sure that stuff isn't going to start smoking, your best bet is to solder the power wires directly to the bottom of the board on both the power input and output connectors. The connectors for everything else are nice locking type connectors, and the matching plugs come with the RepRapElectro RAMBo. Though they are crimp connectors, so you'll get the best results with those connectors if you have the proper crimping tool. They also include an adapter board for the smart controller, which is the full package of a big LCD screen, an encoder input, and an SD card reader. You'll also get three mechanical end stops, along with pre-crimped connectors and wires for those, as well as some wiring for two thermistors and a USB cable. The other spot where they deviate from the reference design are the power MOSFETs. Those are marginally less nice ones here, but they are still very, very decent transistors and a much better choice than, for example, the ones that are used on the RAMs. The RepRapElectro RAMBo is also not the very newest version 1.3, but the older 1.1b version. The only big difference between those is that the USB port is isolated from the rest of the board on the newer versions. Is that a good addition? Yes, it is, but is it something you really need? No, and the RAMBo 1.3 and 1.2 are some of the only or even the only boards that offer isolated USB, simply because it rarely ever becomes an issue that you need to worry about. There are a couple of extra protective measures on the newer RAMBos as well, and those basically protect the board against user error. So, as with every other board, you should take care when handling it. Now, the special thing about RepRapElectro is that even though they are a business from Canada, the actual boards are shipped directly from Hong Kong. They are still made and tested to the standards RepRapElectro sets, but you will have to wait for the Hong Kong Post to deliver your package, along with possibly dealing with and waiting on imports and customs. Hong Kong Post isn't quite as slow as unpredictable as the China Post, but you can still expect to wait on your board for 3 to 6 weeks. Now, because of this, the boards from RepRapElectro aren't quite as expensive as locally grown RAMBOs, which are $170 plus shipping and tax or inputs from Ultimachine, but are also not quite as cheap as the you don't know what kind of components you'll get board from some of the AliExpress sellers, including GTEC, which started about $80 including shipping, but plus imports. RepRapElectro is selling the RAMBo for just below $100, including shipping, as an introductory offer. The regular price will get a bump to $120. Either way, I think it's still a pretty good deal if you're in the market for a RAMBo board, since you're essentially getting a high-quality board for not much more than the ones from AliExpress. So, to sum things up, is the RAMBo a good board? Yes, very much. It's a well-designed board that I'd put in the upper middle class of RepRap boards, since it really is a rock-solid design with a couple of nice features that will make using your printer a good bit more comfortable, like being able to adjust the motor current in software. It's not one of the fancy new 32-bit boards and doesn't have an insane amount of extruder outputs, but it's a very good choice for 99% of all users. Will you want to order it from RepRapElectro? I would. Yes, it's going to take a while to get to you, but other than that, there really isn't anything to complain about. RepRapElectro really seem like good folks. They credit Ultimachine properly and are even working on releasing a complete new FTL licensed user manual for the RAMBo. Plus, it's kind of a good deal, as you basically get to choose between a simple printer board from PrinterBot and a RAMBo from RepRapElectro at currently the same price. So that's it for today. As always, thanks for watching. If you stuck around to this point, congratulations! Let me know what you thought about the length and in-depthness of this review in the comments below.